Philippine President Marcos appoints his personal doctor as chief of the country's Food and Drug Administration. Malacanang notes Dr. Samuel Zacate's years of expertise in medicine and medical consultancy in other government units. These include the Public Attorney's Office and the Presidential Security Group Hospital. Zacate is also a diplomate of the Philippine Society for Venereology and a fellow of the International College of Surgeons. He served as Marcos's lead physician when the president contracted COVID-19 last month.
A Philippine opposition senator seeks a probe into the alleged wastage of billions of pesos worth of COVID vaccines. Senator Risa Ontiveros filed a resolution urging her colleagues to determine why up to 27 million jabs were unused, had expired, and are bound to be thrown away. Ontiveros says these doses are worth between 5 billion pesos and 13 billion pesos. Senator Bongo, the chair of the Senate's health panel, vows an immediate hearing on the expiring jabs once the resolution is referred to the committee. The health department welcomes any possible investigation. It also insists vaccine wastage cannot be avoided.
Bililan natin ang ating populasyon ng Pilipino. Nagkataon, pagdating ng mga bakuna dito, marami ang nagkaroon ng hesitancy. Marami rin po ang hindi pa pumupunta para makakuha ng kanilang scheduled na allocation for the vaccine. So it's not really oversupply.
3,047 new COVID-19 cases are reported in the Philippines on Wednesday. Health officials say 1,011 of this figure were from the capital region. Active cases are nearing the 32,000 mark, while 13 new deaths were also reported. The health department's officer in charge made the rounds in two factories in Cavite Province on Wednesday in a bid to encourage workers to get their COVID booster shots.
This is a big workplace. Gusto natin ipakita sa ating mga kababayan yung pagtutulungan ng local government at saka yung atin pong mga big workplaces like this. Sa kanilang 9,000 plus employees, they have 99% fully vaccinated na mga empleyado. Ang kailangan lang talaga, matulungan natin sila para ma-encourage pa ang kanilang empleyado for their booster shots. Kung saan tayo pwedeng pumunta para mas makapanghikayat, gusto natin yan.
The chair of the Philippine Senate's health panel also seeks to look into the country's readiness to suppress monkeypox. This after the country reported its first case of the disease last week. Senator Bongo has filed a resolution calling for a Senate inquiry to assess the country's response to the new health threat. Go asserts health officials will be asked regarding the measures they have taken against monkeypox.
Philippine Justice Secretary Boyeng Remulla vows to provide the International Criminal Court with details on the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. That's ahead of a September 8 deadline set by the ICC for the Philippines to comment on whether its prosecutor should be allowed to resume its probe into the anti-narcotics campaign. Remulla says among the information they will provide are supposed proof that the justice system in the country is working and why there's no need for the ICC to step in.
I think it's indisputable that our courts are functioning. The prosecution is functioning. This means that we have a functioning judicial system. So I don't think that there's any deprivation involved here, since what is involved is domestic law and the way that we run our country. And it is a democratic country.
There are no more unabated killings as of today. In fact, record shows that there are no unenforced disappearances or torture in the last 3 years. And that means the government is in place and in control. So that is what we believe in, and that is what excludes the ICC from exercising its powers over us. Our institutions are intact and working.
Remulla also claims his agency will spare no one in its review of drug war killings. That's amid criticism that government officials are not part of ongoing investigations.
Kahit sino pa, wala naman tayo sinasanto eh. Kahit sino pa yan, di ba? Bakit nyo ba sasabihin na hindi namin kayang gawin itong bagay na ito? Eh, nasubukan nyo ba yung aming will para maayos lahat yan, di ba? Para naman sobrang loaded yan na you're already presuming something that is not there as a fact. Hindi naman fact yun eh, di ba? I think that's too biased for us to even consider a statement like that.